So a few weeks back, information leaked online of an upcoming game called Agents of Mayhem. It was speculated that since the links were linked to Volition, Agents of Mayhem could either be a new Saints Row game under a codename, or a new IP altogether. Well, Monday the official cinematic trailer for the game came out, and boy, it's definitely not Saints Row 5, but there's still quite a few details that could link it to the Saints Row franchise. Let's take a look at the trailer and speculate where and how this fits into our beloved series. So judging by the robot soldiers and the device which is explained to hold unlimited power, Agents of Mayhem must take place sometime in the future. We also see that all the building billboards and street signs are in Korean. We learn later in the trailer that the city is called Seoul and is located in South Korea. Seoul is also apparently the powerhouse of new technology for the world. Here we see a massive satellite or space station of some kind. It appears to use a giant solar dish. We learn later in the trailer what it's for, but all I know is it must be pretty big in order to block out the sun. Now we get a look at the main enemy in the game called Legion and its leader. Codename Dr. Babylon, real name Osmar Timur, affiliation Ministry of Pride, and specializes in black matter research. It also mentions that his staff can control dark matter and he has a hyperscanner eye and bionic limb. This might be from a previous encounter with the agents or possibly a dark matter lab accident. And now we get to see the first of three agents in the trailer. From the official website, it says you'll be able to switch between three agents at a time in a team. It'll be up to you to mismatch and customize your team to your liking. Anyways, the first agent here is Fortune. Her speciality is in security technology and is equipped with two twin pistols. She's trained as a sky pirate captain, and judging by her ship, the Camo 2, hopefully this means there'll be a good amount of flying vehicles in the game. By now you've probably noticed the purple display. This helps the theory that the agents are somehow connected to the Third Street Saints. I have a theory of my own on this, but we'll get back to that later. Also, people have been saying that Fortune looks a lot like Shandi and could possibly be a future relative. Nothing can be confirmed at this point, but it wouldn't be the first time Volition has put a future relative of Shandi in one of their games. In the background, you can see a billboard with the scientist from the beginning on it. He might be playing a big role in the game, or he might just be someone who gives your characters upgrades. Written on the billboard is Brightest Future. It comes very close to Ultor's slogan, A Brighter Future for a Better Life. Here we get a look at one of Fortune's special abilities, a combat drone called Glory that she ejects off her back to attack enemies. My god. Here's the second agent, Hardtrack. I guess he's trained with the US Navy Command. He uses a teleharpoon? I have no comment. We get a better look at that billboard. The whole thing says, Brightest Minds, the Brightest Future. I forgot to mention earlier that the scientist with the orb device was bringing it to the Tomorrow Tech Expo, as also shown on the sign. So it appears the satellite can harness the power of dark matter, and it can be used to form a giant junk monster. And now we see the third and last agent of the trailer, Hollywood. He's trained as a bounty hunter slash reality TV star and specializes in public relations. Why they didn't choose Johnny Sirhanis to do his voice, I'll never know. Also, this character for some reason reminds me of Joey Tribbiani from Friends.
Ichiban, lipstick for men.
If you go on the Agents of Mayhem website, Yeti is listed as one of the official agents. Currently, though, it only shows a silhouette alongside 9 other unannounced agents. There's a chance that Hollywood Special Ability might be having a stunt double as a suicidal ally. I could be wrong, but it would be pretty funny. Rest in peace, stunt double. Rest in peace. The scientist dude gets kidnapped, so I'll assume you have to try to rescue him in the game. Here we get a pretty good look at the size of Seoul. I've always preferred one large island over small individual ones like Steelport. It looks like there isn't going to be a lot of tall buildings in the city. Hopefully this means Volition spent more emphasis on making unique districts and locations. Underneath each of the holograms, you can see it says Ultor, so I guess the agents are actually working for Ultor, or at least you get funded by them. And here we see a familiar Fleur de Lys. So obviously this game connects to Saints Row in some way or another. On the AOM official website, they say while Agents of Mayhem is a part of the larger Saints Row universe, this is a brand new IP which will focus on a new cast of characters, new gameplay, and a new open world. So based on this information, Agents of Mayhem is either a blood relative to the Row, or my theory is that the game takes place after the events of Saints Row the Third, and Saints Row 4 never happened. So now you're probably thinking what my opinion is of Agents of Mayhem, and well, to be honest, it's definitely not what I was expecting. Before I go off on anything, I'm gonna wait until we get some gameplay at E3. Till then, I hope you guys enjoyed this analysis. If you notice anything I missed, please leave a comment below or join the Saints Row Discord chat where we're currently talking everything Agents of Mayhem related. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Ichiban, lipstick for men.